What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy, the Bearded Trainer, coming at you with a quick Pokemon Go update. I've got a few bits of information that I want to share with you guys. I'm really excited for. But before I get into that, the last couple of days have been real rough. It's been really hard to put out content. And not so much because of the lack of content. There's plenty of content. I work a lot. That being said, I was in a car accident on Tuesday, the 20th. My car got totaled. And I'm dealing with some of that right now. So I'm in the process, God willing, I'll be able to get another vehicle here soon in order to continue bringing the best possible content. Well, it's been really stressful, and I also had to celebrate a birthday yesterday under these circumstances, so I'm a little bit down in the dumps. But that being said, I'm really grateful that I get an opportunity to still bring some kind of video to you guys. I'm gonna do a quick update for you guys, let you know about, we got the Lunar New Year coming up. We have the ability to vote on the next Community Day Pokemon, which I'm really excited for. And then I'm gonna do a quick catch tutorial for you guys, so that way you guys are prepped for that next Community Day. That being said, let's get into it. You know, so we're looking over here at the PokemonGoLive.com. It says Year of the Rat Celebration, Lunar New Year with Pokemon, with Red Minuchino, limited research. So I'm going to just go ahead and go through this. Happy Lunar New Year. The Pokemon Go Lunar New Year event is happening once again, spotlighting various red Pokemon and in celebration of the Year of the Rat, a limited research event featuring Minuchino and Chinchilla, or the Chinchilla Pokemon. Take a look at the details below. Also, from what I understand, there's going to be a lot of cool red Pokemon that you're going to be able to catch out in the wild, such as Red Gyarados. That would be an awesome shiny. Out of all the Pokemon that are going to be available out in the wild, only the Magikarp and the Red Gyarados are going to be the only shiny. I know that there's going to be more appearances of Wild Charmeleon, Fungus, Darumuka, I think, is it? Let's see, let's go through real quick. Certain Pokemon that will be featured are Charmeleon, Vulpix, Parasect, Voltorb, Jinx, Magikarp, Magmar, Flareon, Slugma, Wurmple, of course Wurmple, give you, there's the other opportunity for a shiny, get the purple Wurmple, Corphish, Kricketot, and Fungus will appear more frequently in the wild. You also have the opportunity to potentially run into a Gyarados in the wild, and if you're lucky enough, you can get that shiny red Gyarados. I don't have the red Gyarados yet. I'm looking forward to an opportunity at least getting a shiny Magikarp. So that'll be cool, right? Darumuka, there it is, will hatch from 7K eggs. Some red Pokemon will be hatching from 7-kilometer eggs, such as Shuckle and Fungus. We don't want really a red Shuckle. We're going for the shiny Shuckle, right? I think it's blue. And Fungus, making its Pokemon Go debut, will be Darumuka, the Zen Charm Pokemon. So that is really cool. There should be a graphic right around here somewhere. I'll put it up. Bonuses, gifts, will have a chance to rewarding you with rare candy, so be sure to send out and open lots of gifts with your friends. Be sure to trade more with your friends. The likelihood of becoming lucky friends will be increased during this event. When you trade Pokemon, there will be an increased chance of lucky Pokemon. So it looks like there's a lot of cool trade bonuses. I'm looking forward to that. Here we go, Minuchino and limited research. In celebration of the Year of the Rat, Minuchino, the Chinchilla Pokemon, will be appearing in Pokemon Go for a special limited research event. I can't talk. Professor Willow has uncovered the Minuchino can evolve into a Cinchino. I think I'm saying that right. Don't slaughter me if I'm not. Through the use of a Unova Stone. Alright, so we finally get a use of those Unova Stones once more. I know we got more Unova Pokemon in the game, but I haven't really seen, they've been really more encouraging the trade evolutions versus the Unova Stone evolutions. Not feeling the greatest, but like I said, I'm grateful with the opportunity to be able to bring you another video. This isn't going to be a roundabout video where I get to drive around and go show you some cool stuff due to the absence of my vehicle at the moment, which I am really bummed out about, but you know what? Things happen for a reason. I'm grateful that I'm alive. I'm grateful that I'm in one piece. And that's all that really matters right there. All right, so field research, Minuchino limited research tasks will allow you to encounter Minuchino. Pokemon that fit the theme of the Year of the Rat will be appearing more frequently in the wild. So look out for Rattata, Raticate. Oh, that's great, more rats. Pikachu, Sandshrew, Nidoran, Nidoran male, Nidoran female, Sentret, Meryl, Zigzagoon, Plusle, Minun, Bidoof, and Patarat. Minuchino in 5K eggs. More frequently in 5K eggs. After the event ends, Minuchino will continue to be available in 5K eggs. So that's cool. So they're not just going to close it out just with that. And then, of course, the shiny Minuchino, which you'll see that graphic up here somewhere. It's in this general area right here. If you're lucky, you might encounter one. So That being the first event, and then we have some more news. News coming out here, we got Vote for the Next Community Day, and this came out today, so yes, I get to bring this to you right now. So to allow Community Day to live up to its name and even more, we're letting trainers everywhere vote for the next featured Community Day Pokemon. What will it be? Here's what you can expect for the coming weeks. On Wednesday, January 22nd, 2020, we announced the Pokemon in the running to be featured for Community Day. What their event exclusive move attacks will be, and field research tests that you will need to complete to vote for the Pokemon of your choice. 2. Voting day will be Saturday, February 1st, 2020 from 12 a.m. to 11:59 p.m. 11:59 p.m. in your local time zones. Votes will be counted via the total number of field research tests completed globally within the allotted amount of time. Number 3. On Monday, February 3rd, 2020, 2 days after voting day closes, we will announce the Pokemon which will be featured in February Community Day. Excuse me. 4. The Community Day featuring the winning Pokemon will take place on Saturday, February 22nd, 2020. Featured bonuses will be 3x Stardust, 3x catch Stardust. Community Day for trainers will be in the Northern Hemisphere, will run from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. local time, while in the Southern Hemisphere it will run from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. So your candidates for the next Community Day are Vulpix, Machop, Rhyhorn, and Dratini. Man, we all know that we're going to be trying to go for that Dratini. Everybody wants that Draco Meteor, Dragonite. But if you go to PokemonGoLive.com, you can actually see the entire vlog. I'm looking at it directly from the events tab in my phone. So that's pretty cool. And then Pokemon Go Live events are coming to Taiwan, the UK, and US. This is the big one right here. It looks like the event season is getting ready to start off. We got the Safari Zone and GoFest events. It says the year of 2019 featured an incredible lineup of events for Pokemon Go. From running 3 Pokemon Go Fests across 3 different continents to hosting our first ever Safari Zones in Brazil, Singapore, and Canada. Every year, we aim bigger and better than the last. In 2020, you can look forward to new and even more events and locations. We are pleased to announce the first live events of the year. First is Taiwan Lantern Festival in Taichung City, Thursday, February 6th to Sunday, February 9th, 2020. Safari Zone in St. Louis, Missouri, U.S., Friday, March 27th to Sunday, March 29th, 2020. Safari Zone in Liverpool, the U.K., April 17th to Sunday, April 19th, 2020. Safari Zone, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, U.S., Friday, May 8th to Sunday, May 10th, 2020. So we've got a lot of really cool events already kicking off and planned by Niantic. I'm really excited about this. Maybe your boy, the bearded trainer, will have an opportunity to attend some of these events and bring you the best content I can from those events. I'm looking forward to it. Maybe if it's in the cards, we'll be able to do that. If not, oh well, whatever. But let me know in the comments down below what you think of the news updates. Are we looking for that shiny Greg Gyarados? Are we going to be looking for that Minuchino or that Darmuco? What are you guys looking forward to? What's your favorite event that's coming up? And are you going to be able to attend? I want to go over a quick catch tutorial with you guys too. As we got, as it was announced, February 22nd is going to be the next Community Day. So it's always good to be prepared a little bit in advance. The quick catch method is one of those methods that really helps you cut out the screen time, the catch animation, which saves a lot of time when you're trying to catch clusters. And it can be a pain in the butt sometimes when you have mass clusters around you and you got to sit there and wait through the animation one piece at a time. So we're going to use a little bit off of my my saved researches just to give you guys a quick idea of what that looks like. So, alright, so I'm obviously not in an area where I can actually demonstrate it with Pokemon in the wild, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and open up here in my research because I have stockpiled some for a video that I'm going to do later. So ladies and gentlemen, the whole purpose of the quick catch method is in order to cut the amount of time between the catch animation and catching the next spawn. So I used an ananab berry in order to keep this dugong here in play so I can show you as quickly as I can. But what we want to typically do here is we're going to go ahead and grab onto that. See what I did there? We're going to grab onto the Pokeball tray and we're going to drag it over. You see it moves over a little bit. Then we're going to go ahead and do our catch technique. And boom. Now I pulled the tray out I click on that, and if you look up here, you'll see the little run symbol. I can actually run from that. And now we can go ahead and take a look real quick and see if we caught the dugong. And as you can see right there, the dugong has been caught. Now we're going to do that with one more real quick, just to give you a quick breakdown of what I'm doing exactly the way that I'm doing it. Okay, so we've got the Gastly sitting here on the screen. We're going to go ahead and we're going to pull over on this ball. That's going to drag the tray over a little bit. Then we're going to go for our throw, what just happened? The ball disappeared completely. All right, there we go. I'm going to go for that throw right there. I'm going to pull back, and now I'm going to hit the little run icon up here in the top. And now I've skipped that animation entirely. And as you can see, Gastly's been caught. So ladies and gentlemen, that's essentially the quick catch method. It is very helpful and beneficial when it comes to those community day events, or if you're just trying to sit in a cluster and catch and you want to go as quickly as you can, it allows you to do that as fast as possible. And you can satisfy research pretty quickly. You'll be able to notice by the little requirement met icon that pops up in the bottom right hand corner of the screen once you've satisfied that. So, if you guys did enjoy this video, it's a short video, please go ahead and give me a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, please click that subscribe button. And if you want to be notified whenever I bring new content, click that little bell. It's up here somewhere. I know it's up here somewhere. Up in the top right-hand corner. And you'll be notified whenever I bring new content to the video. Appreciate you guys, and I'll see you around.